and Ron Newton found them mixing the new LP in the south of France.
Bien sûr.
Barricades recorded their albums here. It's a fairly well-known studio, and we thought we'd like to get away from everything to mix the album, because we'd recorded in Munich.
And a challenge. It's actually a working chateau. This is where they make the wine. They just make enough bottles for the groups of coming.
Alcohol in plentiful supply, no doubt.
What's that? The chateau has its own vineyards, and we're allowed to drink as much of it as possible and get as many headaches as possible.
What's this here, then, the chapel?
This is where I live. I actually live in the church. This is the chateau, and that's owned by Jacques Lussier, the famous jazz pianist. And the boys sort of all live all around this village.
Other dorms. It's like me and Stephen Delta House.
Don't you get fed up here? It must be very quiet. How long have you been here?
It is a bit of a change. I mean, I don't think I can spend a whole album's worth here.
So it's 18 months since you last released a single. And now here you are tucked away in this remote part of the south of France. What have you been doing in between?
Making an album, really. That's been about it. We spent the back half of last year in Ireland writing and rehearsing for the album. Since January, we've been in Munich and then on to here.
But we decided after 5 years of constantly keeping the ball rolling that we would take a little rest. Not that we were tired, but we just felt that the music business as a whole needed a rest from us and us from them. And it would be an opportunity for us to sort of look objectively at the whole thing. I mean, ever since we released our first single, we've been in this big snowball that's kept going.
And Top of the Pops tour, album tour.
You begin to lose sort of idea of what you really wanted to achieve at the beginning and or why you're in it. These 18 months have shown us that, you know, we want to get back and have more fun.
Since releasing your last single 18 months ago, you've had a few wrangles with your record company, Chrysalis, and now you signed to CBS, so what was it all about?
We just didn't really see eye to eye on a few things. I suppose it's like things just didn't work out for us, you know, and we felt that it was time to move on, and so therefore we signed with another record company.
We didn't have the right attitude, basically. They didn't treat us as we wanted to be treated.
Did you think they were doing enough for the band?
They didn't. No, I think that.
Well, that's
CBS
really the reason. That's the reason why we left. You know, mm-hmm. But it's no problems now.
Do you ever look back and feel embarrassed or wish that you hadn't done that at the time?
No. I mean, when we wore tea towels and stuff.
Skirts.
She said it, not me.
Skirts, yeah. That was... No.
My mum gets embarrassed.
If it's relevant at the time, though, isn't it? You know, you look back on things and you think, God, did I used to wear things like that? But I mean,
it's like 10 years ago, you might have been wearing flares. I mean, you know, but you don't wear them now. No, it's just... everything we've done because we've done it because we believed in it. And I'm not embarrassed about anything I've done.
What about the music?
It was a nice skirt, though, wasn't it?
we've always had the attitude with making records. I mean, you can look back and see, say, the second album, for example, the second side on that was rather weird.
Experimental.
We were into it at the time. We've never, ever made records to sell for commercial reasons. The only records we've ever made are the ones that we like.
How does your new album differ from the last one, Parade? Because I think a lot of people thought it was very middle of the road and a coffee table album.
Well, obviously we've played live a lot more since then and come together as a band. And we really wanted to capture that sound. Parade was much more of a studio orientated album. As John was saying, this whole album was rehearsed to its fullest live in Ireland. And we decided to use a new producer, Gary Langan. We felt he was more gutsy and he would actually record us as we were. There was always a big difference in Spandau between the sound of the record and the way we sounded live.
People always just say, God, that sounds really good live. You know, why does it sound like that on record? So it's been nice to actually put it down on tape.
Do you get worried after having such a long break that your fans won't be there when you come back with this album and single?
I don't think so. I mean, we'll be nervous on the first Tuesday morning, first chart morning, but then we always are.
I mean, I don't think nothing's happened. In a year and a half we've been away, it's such a good opportunity. Now, there's without us and without Duran Duran and without Frankie around, it was a great opportunity for new bands to come through and steal the whole show from us. We don't want to sound conceited. I'm disappointed that nothing really terribly exciting has happened in Britain. I mean, the bands that appeal to me, such as Simple Minds and people like that, have been successful for a lot longer. The only new band I really like is probably In Excess, and they're an Australian band.
I think a lot of people seem to think it's the superstar syndrome, though, coming to a place like this. Sort of typifies what you're all about.
It's just a great place. It's not, you know, nothing to do with, you know, superstars and all that. It's a good studio. It's a lovely environment. The sun's shining, and it makes us feel happy. And if we feel happy while we're recording and mixing the album, then that's good.
The thing that strikes me about you is that you get on so well. You're very close, and you're full of enthusiasm, which a lot of bands who've been going as long as you have lost a long time ago.
Yeah.
You know, why is it then?
I don't know. It's pretty hard to analyse it, but you know, the chemistry is obviously right. I mean, we were friends before the band, which obviously helps. But yeah, no arguments really.
I think it's because we are very different people, and we all fulfil all our personalities breathe quite successfully within the band. Together, we make a really good unit, and there doesn't seem to be any ego problems amongst us lot. I think we all know how much we need each other, and we enjoy that. And it's a sort of real spirit amongst us lot. It's like this whole thing's been one busman's holiday, you know, and the Beano's still rolling.